Training and certification are highly recommended for all individuals working with pressurized fluid. This could include a basic hydraulics or pneumatics training course, or could include actual certification, such as our hydraulic specialist or mobile hydraulic mechanic, just as examples. Many employers and businesses offer on-the-job training as well. It's important just to be trained and to be aware of all of the potentials that exist and understand the equipment that you're working on or designing. You can check out the IFPS website for all of the available certifications that are offered, and that's at www.ifps.org/certifications-offered. Always use eye protection. If using pressurized air for cleaning equipment, do so with extreme caution. Never apply compressed air to the skin or direct it at a person. That air can cause serious injury. When using compressed air for cleaning purposes, ensure that the pressure at the nozzle exit does not exceed 30 psi. You do not want to use compressed air to clean dust or debris off of your body or from your clothing. Take care also not to blow any dirt in the direction of other people or personnel in the area or even into machinery. So if you have a machine that's running, you want to make sure you're not blowing that dust into the air intake, potentially causing problems on the machine as well. Filters and lubricators that are equipped with a metal bowl guard should not be operated with the guard removed. The guard is intended to be a safety and retention device to prevent the bowl from blowing off during normal operation and to also keep that bowl protected from exterior damage. Also, when using a filter within pneumatic system, the condensate that's collected in an air filter or the separator must be disposed of in accordance with federal, state, and local environmental regulations. This includes the disposal of the filter element as well, not just the condensate. Oftentimes, the condensate, when it settles out within that filter element or within the bowl, it can include oil, water, and other contaminants that may be hazardous to the environment that would have to be disposed of properly. Because oil mist is a potential hazard to personnel, OSHA mandates allowable exposure limits. So this is giving you a guideline to different contamination levels within air, both from presence of particles, water, and oil. In cases where you're using oil lubricators, it may be important to recognize that the use of a coalescing muffler might be required at the end of an quick exhaust valve that may be required both by employer regulation and also government regulation. So in this case, OSHA may require that to be in place in pneumatic systems that have quick exhaust valves. Regular inspection of vacuum pads is necessary for continued safe performance and operation. Here are just shown four examples of industrial applications that are using vacuum pressure to either pick or hold components in position during a manufacturing or assembly process. Any damage to the pad should be remedied at the sign of inspection. So if you find a pad that has damage, that's either torn, it has perhaps a crease in the lip of the suction cup that's preventing it from sealing properly, those must be replaced immediately to ensure that a proper safety margin is still present within the design of the system. When it comes to pneumatic systems, relieving regulators are designed for non-combustible gas service. Any device that uses oxygen service must be properly cleaned for that service, and it must be a non-venting regulator type, as can be seen by the lack of venting port on the image on the right. So these are the schematics showing a vented regulator on the left and a non-vented regulator on the right. Non-vented regulators are then designed for use with toxic, combustible, or oxygen displacing gases. It's critical to ensure that the proper type of regulator is used for the specific applications. When it comes to pneumatic system, whether this is shop air within a workshop or air that's used for pneumatic system through an assembly line, do not use frayed, damaged, or deteriorated hoses. Always store hoses properly and away from any heat source or direct sunlight. A failure in the hose can cause serious injury, and want to inspect the hoses on a regular basis and before each use. Remember that injuries related to a hose failure are not limited to just high pressure hydraulic hoses. When it comes to inspections, check the tubing, the hoses, and the couplings daily before each use. Use only connectors and conductors that are designed to handle compressed air. Want to provide all couplings with a positive locking device. Here in the middle is shown a Chicago style fitting that's coupled together with wire or clips. So in this case, the clip is present here. This is just showing one half of it, but when the mating half is connected, it's then using a clip to keep that connected for a proper positive lock or engagement. Also shown are quick release style couplings, as is shown here on the image in the upper right. And this style of pneumatic fitting has a push release to disconnect the fitting. So the hose tubing is inserted into the fitting and then locks in place to maintain that positive lock.